This is one of the best tools you have for keeping your watercolours vibrant. White paper in watercolour is your lightest light. If you can get used to leaving areas of white paper in your painting, you'll keep them alive. So let's use it. This is my aunt's lounge with the sun streaming through the window. A great subject to show you just how effectively reserving white paper can be. As we did in the previous sketch, let's put the shadows in first. I'm using Prussian blue and a nice big fat number 12 brush so I can make nice big positive brush strokes. Don't have to labour on with lots of little fiddly marks. And then while my washes are wet, I'm running in some of this lovely red colour of the curtain here. In fact, I might use a different brush for that, a little slightly smaller brush, another size 7. And I can keep the Prussian blue on my brush for the other shadows. Remember, I'm reserving white paper. So the first time I'm reserving it is up here where the light has come across these curtains. So let's take the shadow across the curtains from the window pane and leave the light at the edge of the curtain there. And look at this lovely broken edge you get to the brush stroke if you don't start fiddling around too much. Back to the Prussian blue, and now let's go over the cushions. A bit lighter, not too heavy a wash this time because it's the shadows cast across the cushions again from the window. All the while thinking, what white paper am I leaving? What is the paper I'm leaving? That's the most important thing to show this sunlight. Shadows again across the cushion here. And you don't have to be too accurate. If you just bring the brush strokes and the shadow lines across the top of the sofa, using the shape of the brush to help you do it. The actual foreground is very dark indeed, so we can bring that Prussian blue much more neat in under the front of these cushions. And there's some lovely little shadows just behind this. We're leaving out the white paper again for the piping around the cushions. And now the newspaper, we're going to leave the newspaper out from the wash because the newspaper's white. Well, I think actually it's the Financial Times, I think it's pink. But we need a shadow within the fold and a touch of the red into the shadow of the paper, just there where it's catching some pink light. And then we carry on building with this Prussian blue these lovely dark shadows all the while we're painting round the white paper that we're leaving. So in fact, we're actually not painting the blue, we're painting the white by painting round it, if that makes sense. Never be afraid of the rough edges of your washes. It's the actual tooth of the paper in watercolour that is so lovely and so alive. Not only is the white paper important to the life of a watercolour, but this actual raggedy edges that come when the brush comes over the tooth. You can buy rougher papers for getting more tooth, or you can buy smoother papers, but just use that tooth when you've got it. Right, let's see, we've still got some shadows over this sofa made from the pots of plants on the window, or cast by the pots of plants on the window. Most of the pots on the window are sort of a red terracotta colour, so I'm going to mix the Prussian blue and the red together. And look, we get this perfect browny reddy colour. Again, remember you're leaving the white paper out where you want the sparkly lights. Just to catch even the rims of these little saucers, we can leave a little white rim above the saucer beneath the pot. And the shadows that the pots are casting on the sills, even they have a little touch of the red into the wash. And now just pulling those out while they're still wet. Remember, all the while we're leaving this white paper where we want light. We have light creeping in under these little saucers, sort of creeping round them. all the top of the windowsill is lit by the sun coming from it. Leave it white. I'm going to use aureolin where it's lightest and brightest, and again I'm going to leave the edge of the wall, the white paper, but I can come over the actual window frames because they are actually darker than the outside world. Coming round, here's lots of light on the side of this plant here, so I'm coming right round that, but I can go across any of the plant that is darker. And I'm just going to add a bit of Prussian blue into that aureolin to make that a little bit greener. As it comes round behind there. Keeping the top of the windowsill. A little tiny bit of red I'm going to put in there just to kill off the green a bit. It's a little bit bright for me. Come up behind these pots, leaving the top of the windowsill, keeping that white paper so you're catching the light. Sometimes it's only tiny bits of white paper you're leaving. Other times it's great swathes of it. But it's just being sensitive. That paper is life to the painting. Lovely red flowers. We'll go round them with the background colour. Now they're not going to stay as white paper, they're going to be red. But by the same token, you don't want any other colour over them, so leave them as white paper for the time being. And I'm even going to leave some little lines of white down the stems of this geranium, just where it picks out as the light shines on it. So there's little sparkles of white paper. Frame of the window has got, this photograph's got a lovely sort of red tinge to it. I'm going to just use some of that red, just tint the frame, the window frame, against the light. You don't see much of it because it's mostly hidden by the flowers, but just bring it in behind here. It's a bit too wet there to do that there yet, but I can come up the side of here where this plant's stem is. And then while it's still slightly wet, I'm going to add the red of the geraniums just so they're just a little bit blur edged, not too hard. And again, leaving little bits of white paper so that you can feel the light dancing on the petals. You look at the world, it's always this mosaic of lights and darks. It's never solid. And watercolour does this so well. So just let the paper do the work for you. Let the brush do its bit. All you've got to do is sit back and enjoy it. Little bit of pink, a bit of permanent rose here. I'm just going to put for these little flowers here. And look, let the brush stroke, see the edge of the brush? The actual brush itself is making. I'm not going like this, trying to make each petal. I'm letting the brush do it with its own little life. And these leaves over here on this little rubber plant, we can again use the brush stroke to make the shapes of these leaves. A slightly variation of colours, a little bit more aureolin, a little less Prussian blue. Even in a quick sketch like this, you can see how reserving the white paper keeps the painting fresh.